لله الحمد لله نحمده نستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا شيء مثله ولا شيء يعجزه قديم بلا ابتداء دائم بلا انتهاء لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام حي لا يموت قيوم لا ينام وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا وشفيعنا ونور أبصارنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم هو خير نبي أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله وأحثكم ونفسي على طاعته وأحذركم وبال عصيانه ومخالفة أمره فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره أما بعد فيا أمة الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الرسل كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا إني بما تعملون عليم وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاتقون فتقطعوا أمرهم بينهم زبرا كل حزب بما لديه فرحون فذرهم في غمرتهم حتى حين أيحسبون أنما نمدهم به من مال وبنين نسارع لهم في الخيرات بل لا يشعرون الآيات في سورة المؤمنون الله سبحانه وتعالى in this آيات give us many points when you recite the آيات of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes you have to listen and think about the meaning and they apply this meaning in your life Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayat, He starts, Ya ayyuha rusul, O messengers. There is ma'na khas wa ma'na am. Al ma'na khas, special meaning, the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the special meaning. Al ma'na am, general meaning, every one of us is messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because your job in this dunya to receive the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only to get the message from the messengers and the prophets, and you keep this message and you don't pass it to the people, then there is generation after you, and there is generation after that until the day of judgment. That's how we receive this message to this generation right now after 1400 years. يا أيها الرسل, O messengers, كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا. Eat from good things, طيبات. And after that, do good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, hadith Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, I know I did mention this hadith before, but let me remind you and remind myself about the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. That man who is Ash'ath Aghba, tired from the traveling, and you know, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he mentioned the condition of this man. وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامُ, his food from haram. وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامُ, his drink from haram. وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ, his clothes from haram. وَغُذِّيَ بِالْحَرَامُ, he is feeding himself and his children from haram. Then in the end of the day, when he made mistakes, he go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. And he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala time after time, O Allah, forgive me. O Allah, erase my mistakes and my sins. O Allah, please remove this ghumma, remove this hard things and hardness about me. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم in his hadith يقول أَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his dua? And everything in behind is wrong. His food haram, his drink haram, his clothes from haram, everything he's getting from haram. Then in the end of the day, you want to go to Allah and ask him, and Allah will forgive you right away? There is judgment. There is hukum. There is system. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made all this universe running with perfect system. وَكُلُّهُ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. And if, imagine this system about this universe. Yani if this sun come little close to the earth, what's gonna happen? The earth could be burned. If this sun go little further, 1 mile, the earth will freeze. Look at the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about something in the Quran or through the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, mean this is system. This is your manual as Bani Adam. If you follow this manual, then you will be safe in this dunya and in the akhirah. But if you have your own manual, then different case. You have to find your desire, and then the end Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going to be your end. يا أيها الرسل كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا. O messenger of Allah, and every messenger after that, and every one of us is messenger, because your job is to pass the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the people. لذلك Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his name is As-Salam. His name is As-Salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger order us to spread As-Salam between us. And Salam is peace. Spread the peace. Ya ayyuha rusul, كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows what you're doing in this life, and everything is recorded by Raqib and Atim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيمٌ. Every single word you read or you mention or you pronounce is going to be Raqib and Atim. Every single step, wherever you go, there is Raqib and Atim. They are writing what you're doing. Every single side you look, wherever you look, you look. That is Raqib and Atim. ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيب. لذلك in the day of judgment, therefore in the day of judgment, therefore who did bad things in the day of judgment, the book will be opened and everyone will see the book. ووضع الكتاب. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة الكهف بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ووضع الكتاب. The kitab will be opened. فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ. Those who did bad in this life, they are shaking and they are worrying what's in this book. فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ وَيَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. Every single word or letter or anything in this book. Allah Akbar. So everything is recorded. How come? يعني what is the miracle of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala for every single person, every word, everything is recorded until the day of judgment. Right now, maybe if you tell the people something like this, like 100 years ago, they will, you know, some people they believe, some people they don't. But right now, little chip like this, you know, you can record millions and millions of pages. How come the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة. This ummah, the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, is ummah واحدة. It is one ummah only. Sometimes people they want to divide this ummah between madahib, between sharaya, between adyan, between this and that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many places in the Quran, He mentioned, you are one ummah since Adam alayhi salam till the last person in the universe. Since Adam alayhi salam, and it's only one deen. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, inna ad-deena inda Allahi al-Islam. Deen is al-Islam only. Well, Islam is not to say I am Muslim, but al-Islam kama ja. مَنْ سَلِمَ النَّاسُ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَيَدِهِ. If the people they are saved from your tongue and your evils, then you are Muslim. حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يقول والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن والله لا يؤمن 3 times. النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم is swearing by Allah سبحانه وتعالى 3 times. And he doesn't need to swear. And he said 3 times, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min. Means there is something very important after that. What is Ya Rasulullah? He said, Man la ya'manu jarahu bawa'iqa. The one who his neighbor does not save from his evil. Allahu Akbar. Yani, is it your neighbor very important like this? You're not mu'min, your iman not complete. If you're bothering your neighbors, in Islam, yes. That's how should be our relationship between you and your brother. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He said you have to be one ummah, one person. إذا اشتكى منهم عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. If one part of this body gets sick, the whole body should be stand up. This is the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاتقون. Sometimes people, they worry about themselves only. And they don't care about, you know, the generation after that or the people after them. Like, you know, many times, but right now, you know, you see people in the, you know, park or somewhere, you know, they eat and they drink and they throw the, you know, trash around and they don't care. And the same thing for parking, especially in old masajid, by the way. Sometimes they park the parking and they don't care about the people who's coming after them. You're coming to the masjid to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make something good. So you start your day or you start your deed to block the parking of the people, to park in the middle of the road. That's not right. So when you come and you want to do something good, you have to do it, you know, all of it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if you late for a few minutes, it's okay. But it's more important to be nice and to be good. One time, Kisra was, you know, walking and he saw old man. He's very old man. And this man, he's planting olive tree. And you know, olive tree is gonna take long time, about 30 years to get the fruits, to get the oil. And then you collect the oil, olive, and you know, you make it. It's gonna take long time, like maybe more than 30 years. So Kisra, he asked, why you're doing this? And you'll be not able to collect the fruits of this tree. You're planting and you're old man and you're working hard the whole day and you know this seed is gonna take more than 30 years and you're old man, you're gonna die. He said, the people before us, they planted for us. And now we collect what they planted, what they did before. Now we are collecting what they did before. And now what we did, the generation after us, they will get the fruits of this. So right now, we need to ask ourselves, what we are doing for our children and grandchildren and grandchildren, what you are gonna leave after you die? You abuse your health or your time, and you know, you are using all the time from 6 in the morning till 8 in the evening. You are in the job, busy here and there. And many people now, they are wasting time, hours and hours and hours, you know, in the Facebook and Viber and Twitter and you name it. You know, there is many things. And believe me, hours and hours and hours, they are wasting for nothing. Just watching people, they go to the restaurant, they take picture for every plate. You know, we went to the restaurant today, look at this. And they start taking pictures. We go somewhere, they start taking pictures, and you know, and they are just wasting time and wasting money and wasting everything. And our time is, you know, if you don't feel the value of your time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you, then you don't, you know, feel the responsibility Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you not to waste your time here and there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you to use your time to elevate yourself. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to study, to be a strong mu'min and a strong Muslim. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاتَّقُونَ. This is message, be careful. This is message not for non-Muslim people, not for Christian, not for any, no. This is this message for the people who believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاتَّقُونَ. I am your Lord, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever you use your time, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you raise your children, according to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you deal with your wife. Don't abuse your wife. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you deal with the people in your job. You buy and sell. Samhan iza ba'a, samhan iza ishtara. You have to be nice and good and soft when you buy or you sell. All that from the akhlaq of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's teaching us in every single word or amal. لأن السنة قولية فعلية. Two kind. A sunnah, either way. What the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, or what he did by his actions. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba kiram, they used to see him, how he make wudu, they make like him. صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Even the masajid, and this is making you, sometimes sad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول لَمَسْجِدٌ أُسِّسَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى لَمَسْجِدٌ أُسِّسَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى مِنْ أَوَّلِ يَوْمٍ أَحَقُّ أَنْ تَقُومَ فِيهِ. Masajid, sometimes people, they get like a couple of people and they came with the idea, let's go and open the masjid. And they think building make people. And this is, the Quran oftentimes came to correct our understanding. Because building these stones or wood or whatever, ceiling and, all that walls, does not make people. But people, they are able to make people. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم in Mecca, and he is النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم who came رحمة للعالمين, who came رحمة للعالمين. 10 years in Mecca from the da'wah of النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم did not build a masjid. Is he able to do that or not? Yes, he is able. But he built more than masjid. Because he built people like Umar and Uthman and Ali and Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhum. He built people who built the whole Ummah after him. This is more important. And right now people, they want to go and make just a building. And they don't care. And they start with this. And after that they start calling themselves shuyukh and ulama. And after that, they start giving fatwas. And after that, they start, giving hukum and all that. And there was Allah and Allah, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. This is from Alamat al-Sa'ah, from the sign of the Day of Judgment. And Allah subhanahu sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam yaqul about those people, from the sign of the judgment. يُكَذَّبُ فِيهَا الصَّادِقُ وَيُصَدَّقُ فِيهَا الْكَاذِبُ. The one who is truthful, people, they don't take his words, as, right words. And those people who, try to make a frame for the words and all that, and try to make funny things, they love him. Because he know how to talk, he know how to, And in the end, النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يقول وَيَنْتِقُ فِيهَا الرَّمَيْبِضَ. And this is a new word for the, as-sahaba al-kiram. They ask him, Ya Rasulullah, what does that mean, al-rawaybida? Al-rajul al-tafih. Al-rajul al-tafih means in Arabic, the man who doesn't know anything, and he's, he's jahil, 100%. Al-rajul al-tafih yutakallamu fi amr al-amma. He doesn't know anything and he wants to give fatwa for everyone. There is two kinds of people, two kinds of jahil. There is some jahil, they agree, we are jahil and we want to learn. This one, yes, you have to teach him and you have to take care of him. Because he understands, he doesn't know. That's okay. But there is other kind, they are jahil and they think they are alim. They are worse, walayyadu billah. And this is the big problem over here. Because when you're jahil and you don't want to, to learn anything and you think you're alim, that's a big problem. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاتَّقُونَ. In another surah, in Surah Al-Hashr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. Oh, who believe Allah, fear Allah. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is talking to the mu'mineen. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Oh, who believe Allah. Listen to the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala carefully. Because this message direct to you as a mu'min. If you're mu'min, if you are in the community of mu'mineen, then listen to the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqullah, fear Allah. What I'm doing? Oh man, I'm praying, you know, 5 times. I'm giving zakah, sadaqah, all that is perfect. So you tell me, fear Allah. One time I went to somebody and you tell me, Taqillah? You ain't Taqillah. What are you talking about? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's talking to me, ittaqullah. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ. Look at what you are doing for tomorrow. And tomorrow means the day of judgment. Means could be tomorrow your day of judgment. Because if you die, then it's going to be your day of judgment, because it's going to be down payment in your grave. Your grave is going to be, you know, rawda min riyad al-jannah aw hufra min hufar al-niran, either way, part of the jannah or part of the hellfire. Wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat lighadin. Look at what you are doing for tomorrow. Wattaqullah. Two times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah is telling us, fear Allah, fear Allah. Wherever you are, fear Allah. اتق الله حيث ما كنت. I'll finish with hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Anbiya, in the beginning of Surah Al-Anbiya, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. Al-Hisab is very close to us. And the day of judgment, according to the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also, بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةَ كَهَاتَيْنِ. He said, I came with the day of judgment like these two fingers. How close to each other. بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةَ كَهَاتَيْنِ. And it's been 1400 years. Means we are very close to the day of judgment. فالله سبحانه وتعالى he said إن اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. Your hisab is very close, your judgment is very close to you, and you are still, you're turning around and you don't look to the ayat of Allah and the message of Allah and the sunnah of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's strange. وهم في غفلة معرضون. You are in غفلة, you are in deep sleeping. You're sleeping very deep. We need to wake up. We need to wake up and open our eyes, our heart, our mind to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and start applying this book and this sunnah in our real life. We are masters in talking, but in our actions, we are missing lots of the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu يقول أن رجلا سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Man came to النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and he asked him متى الساعة. O Messenger of Allah, when is going to be the day of judgment? فالنبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم he asked him وما أعددت لها. What you prepare for that day? What you prepare for that day? Did you prepare good deeds? Did you clean your heart and your deeds and your amal? Or you just asking and you want to know some information? ما أعددت لها? What you prepare for that day? For that man, look at this, يعني, Hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, always you know, like a message to us, to make us understand the book of Allah and the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, مَا عَدَتْكُ لَهَا مِنْ كَثْرَةِ There is riwayah. It says, مَا عَدَتْكُ لَهَا مِنْ كَثْرَةِ صَلَاةٍ وَلَا صِيَامٍ وَلَا زَكَاةٍ I don't have lots of salah or siyam or zakah. I did my furud. I did, you know, my siyam, Ramadan. I did my zakah. What is fariḍah? But, لَكِنِّي أُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولِهِ But I love Allah and His Rasul. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم he said, يحشر المرء مع من أحب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather you with who you love. Now, it's very sensitive. Who is in your heart? You love Allah, you love Rasulullah? You have to explain that by your actions. If you love someone, then you have to follow him. And some people, they when they love, you know, like, you know, some singers or something like this, they follow them, you know, when they're walking, when they're driving, when you see the people, how they, you know, when they're driving, they start shaking like this. Because sometimes they don't know what they are doing. But they are singing. And the same thing, if you love the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you follow him by your action, by your speech, by your, you know, activity. Everything should be following the sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow the right sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّهُ سَمِيعٌ قَلِيمٌ مُجِيبُ الدُّعَاءِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ يَا رَبَّ الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده نستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله هو خير نبي ارسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. عباد الله اوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئه ان تقوى الله وحفكم ونفسي على طاعته احذركم وبال عصيانه ومخالفه امره واسال الله سبحانه وتعالى ان يجعلنا من عباده الصالحين الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه. اللهم انا نسالك ايمانا دائما وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وعلما نافعا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم ارحمنا فانك بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فانك علينا قادر. اللهم شاف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وارحم موتانا وفك قيد اسرانا. لا تجعل فينا شقيا ولا محروما ولا مطرودا من رحمتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم من اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه اليه ومن اراد بهم شرا فخذه اخذ عزيز جبار منتقم. اللهم انا نسالك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في هذا اليوم المبارك وفي هذه الساعة المباركة ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته وعافيته ولا بعيدا عنك إلا إليك قربته ولا مسلما إلا نصرته ولا ظالما إلا خذلته وقسمته ولا عاصيا إلا هديته ولا حاجة لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها يا قاضي الحاجات يا قاضي الحاجات يا قاضي الحاجات يا منتهى الغايات يا رب الأراضين والسماوات. اللهم لجأنا إليك يا رب العالمين وأنت قلت وقولك الحق ادعوني أستجب لكم وها نحن ندعوك يا رب العالمين ونرجو منك الإجابة ونرجو منك الرحمة ونرجو منك المغفرة. اللهم فرج عن إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم خذ بأيديهم يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل بلادنا آمنة مطمئنة في حفظك وأمانك يا أرحم الراحمين. اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولأرباب الحقوق علينا، وارحمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقيم الصلاة.